not to indicate to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all, from working at all, from working at all.
Don't lay down and die because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite, when they're coming to take your freedoms away.
Well, hello again, human beings from the planet Earth, and happy Monday. I'm going to take you on a little walk here. Started on my little tangent here, and I'm going to try to be nice about this, so we won't have to worry about language on this one, although I have just had enough. Probably had so much that doesn't even need to be yelled about. But I saw this on Facebook, which just really got my mind turning about we've got to shut this thing down. 87 millionaires in the Senate, 295 millionaires in the House. That tells you right there who's controlling this country. The elite. Period. We don't need to have any more discussion about it. We really don't. But we have to, huh? Because you're like sheep. You'll just keep taking it and taking it and taking it. And not only taking it, but justifying it as you scamper along. Bah. No, I'm not taking it. I'm not. And hopefully I only give you enough information in this video that you'll get irritated at me and you'll try to prove me wrong. That's what I want. I don't want you to listen to me. I don't want you to take my word as God. I want you to go ahead and prove me wrong. And do it. Don't just run your pie hole in the comments. Show me some links and prove that I'm wrong. Give me some science. Give me some facts. Give me some testimony of the people that are out there dying in our very own streets from hunger. Give me something. But I'm going to give you the little bit that I got right now, and then you can scamper on your way and either run away in denial, or you can come back with... you probably won't be coming back with anything that can rebut what I'm going to tell you. Okay. Moving along on our little walk. The next thing we see is that we spend almost as much to kill people as we do to keep them alive. That's just ridiculous. I don't... No. No, no, no. I'd like to see a little fraction like this, because you got to have some protection, and then a big fraction like this of keeping people alive. Okay. That's not happening, is it? I want to remind you with the Obamacare hype that you can nullify it state by state. It's not. It's an illegal order. It's a monopoly. It's not what we do, and you don't have to comply. Okay. Don't have to comply with any of this, actually. By the end of this, hopefully you'll see that. Now, what else is our government doing? Because the point of this is that you need to shut this government down. It's gone way beyond foul. It's gone way beyond terroristic, controlling, abusive, and all those foul words that we swore we would never be. It's gone way past that. Now, Obama, with the selling of the water to China... And now some of you are going to justify this because we owe China so much. And hey, we have water. Let's use it and make some money and get on our feet. Yeah, sheep. Okay, first of all, we don't have the right to sell that water. That's not our water. Maybe it touches our land, but it also feeds all these farmers in Canada. There is another map that'll show you thousands and thousands of acres that'll be devastated in Canada. We're selling our Canadian brothers and sisters' rights right out from underneath their nose, and you think it's okay to do that. It's not okay to do that. No. And if I were Canada, I would wage war against this. You're taking away my food supply. You're taking away my water. You're taking away my life. Sneaky, out of the ground, like... stealing somebody's house, everything in it, by coming in the basement. That's exactly what's happening here. Can't tolerate it. Don't condone it. Won't be a part of it. Shut it down. That was the point. Then, this was a little while ago. Nobody seemed to care about this either. Obama just flies through the Monsanto Protection Act. We know Monsanto and the things that they produce are killing people, mutating plants, animals, human life itself. And so we just sign this through, and the act is written by Monsanto-sponsored senator, one of these guys that's right here, 87 millionaires. One of them got rich this way. Well, probably already was rich and just added to his fat stash. Yeah, while you're going hungry. All right, and then I want to show you here. This is over at my blog. Couple of things. Is your national debt? Show you this all the time. It doesn't seem to matter. Fuck it. As long as there's checks, I got money. Right? That doesn't... Okay, so nobody... Since 1950, 32 wars, or deceptive word, operations. And if you go listen to the low-key song Abomination, since 1945, we've attempted to overthrow more than 50 foreign governments. This is we the people doing this. Because you're so hung up on the fact that the government that's in place now is your government. So you got to own this. You got to own the fact that you spend almost as much to kill people as you do to feed them. You've got to recognize that you won't take your rights. Either that or you love so Obama so much you're going to allow your whole state to be affected by him. Okay? How much more? How much more are you going to take? How much more are you going to be responsible for? Even though you're not really the one controlling any of it, are you? I know, you voted. You think you're fine. You think you can't prove that your vote even counted. Show me proof. You can't do it. It's all synthetic. It's all digital. It's all made up. We don't even know. No. And even if you did vote, it's gone way past heinous. Well, listen, when you're hanging around with this many millionaires, you see how many? That's over 300 people, almost 400 millionaires run your country. Tell you how much food you can eat, how much health you can, okay? Social Security, discretion. I don't know where the food comes into this. Evidently, we don't break down how much we're willing to give people. It's probably a little slice off the corner of this Medicare thing here, right? It certainly isn't in the defense spending. We're not going to feed the people we're killing. No. So you don't even know how much you're spending to feed people, but I'm sure it's a small fraction. Okay. Remember Thomas Jefferson's words. Now, I know that some of you are even going to come to me saying that since 1776 and now, somebody put some additional verbiage on a piece of paper that negates this right, and I'm going to tell you to go fuck yourself. Excuse my language. I'm trying not to do that, but you just don't even go there, okay? This isn't because of the fact that it was written on paper that this applies. This is because we're human beings that this applies, and Thomas Jefferson recognized it, and it's about time that you start recognizing it. To secure these rights, governments are instituted among men. Among. Derived their just powers from the consent of the governed. That's you. You're giving your consent to kill as many people as you put in the hospital and take care of. That you're giving consent to continually attempt to overthrow foreign governments. And all you need, again, is something written on paper that says they might harm us. You don't need anything other than that. You'll agree to it. Dance in the street for it. Probably have a holiday. Whenever any form of government becomes so destructive to these ends, it is the right of the people to alter or abolish it and to institute new government, laying its foundation in such principles and organizing its powers in such form as to them shall be most likely to affect their safety and happiness. Prudence, indeed, will dictate that governments long established should not be changed for light and transient causes. These are not light, and these are not transient causes. Killing people every day. Every day. Letting the corporations write our laws. It's not just because I don't think it's right. It's not because I don't like it. It doesn't appeal to me. Transient issue would be something, the sun's too hot today. Things that change very quickly. Our food doesn't change very quickly. Actually, it is starting to change very quickly, and it's because of things like this. There's one other thing that you... took me a long time to find this, even though I knew it existed, but because of the way Google works, they're only going to give you the current information, and you're going to end up pounding your brain to find things like this. The right of revolution. And this isn't because a government said so. This is because free people throughout the history of the world have said so. The right of revolution is the right or duty, variously stated throughout history, of the people of a nation to overthrow a government that acts against their common interests. Belief in this right extends back to ancient China and has been used throughout history to justify various rebellions, including the American Revolution. So if any of you up until that point were thinking, well, this doesn't apply to us, Kevin, and you're, yeah, I know, just for watching the video, you could be a terrorist. And God forbid the guy that puts out a video like this. Yeah, NDAA, just come right in right now. Come in, sweep me away from my three kids. Not tell my mom and dad or any of you what happened. And stay there indefinitely. You come to my house and try that. Somebody is going to die. And it probably very well will be me, because you already know and you're going to come with guns. And you've taken my guns. And so, that will be the end of life. But at some point, somebody will know that, because you know what? There's three kids watching. And they believe very closely to the things I believe in. And that's not a forced belief. They like to be free, too. They like to feed their neighbors. They don't like to drop bombs on them. They like to have their water, not sell it away. They don't hang out with people like this. So it doesn't really matter. But I'm telling you, it's time to shut it down, people. It's absolutely time to shut it down. We can't justify it. We can't take responsibility for it. The entire planet is being affected by this one little nation. Look at us compared to the size of the planet. We don't have any more right than any of these other people. Certainly we don't have the right to sell Canada's water from them. They're much bigger than we are. Wouldn't they have more right to this water? Oh, and by the way, you selfish bastards that are only concerned with what's going on inside your state, you see all these areas? Yeah, those are your own people, and they don't have enough water either. Anybody that debates me that it's time to shut the government down is a fool. It is an absolute fool. You are not going to vote your way out of this, people. You're not going to. Been here 100 years, right? A little more, a couple hundred years. It's time for it to go. And if you think that long-established government is the amount of time that we've been here, no, that's not long-established. That's about how long it was set up to live. And it's dying. It's dying. And if you go Google up today, I don't have a link in front of me, I'm not going to bother showing you, but you can find a map that says even Wall Street is at the same point it was in the 30s. We're on the precipice of another major economic collapse. You're going to be made to be subservient. You're going to be made to keep this government in place, because you don't have the resources that you need to feed yourself or to drink water. You don't have any of those resources. We're so overbuilt that the inner cities and even the suburbs, you can't even grow a garden unless you're threatened with arrest, because it's not appropriate greenery. I really hate to laugh about it, but again, I'm trying not to swear. I hope you guys will really think about that this year. In my opinion, no voting should go past your state level. Locally, yes. Your towns, your counties, your states. And from there, the governors need to take this country over, people. and you must demand that they do. We need some reasonable... We can't just go out into the street with a gun and a mask on and say we're taking this shit back, because that will offend the general populace. It will push the general populace away. We do need to do it by voting, but not at the federal level. And you must take to the streets with your guns and masks in your own states, not tramp down to D.C. There's no reason to go there. No. Half of them aren't there anyway, and if you get close, you're going to be under arrest. Go to your state capitals, go to your city towns, your county buildings, and demand that we take this country back. Elect new governors, throw them out, they can be arrested too. I'm sure there's something with all the information that's available and as foul as everybody has gotten. I'm sure there's some reason that we could dig up and arrest almost any one of the governors that exist right now. And no, I don't know them all personally. I'm not here to debate them. But I think for legitimacy and a true voice of the people, the governors should handle this. That they are the heads of our states. We are independent sovereign states with a common union. We are not one landmass. We have individual rights according to each state and each state's needs and the thoughts of the people in that state. There is no need for a federal government, first of all. No, you handle your own shit. If you need a little help from your neighbor, then your neighbor should be willing to help. That's the only part of the federal government, to coordinate the surplus of some states to get it to the other states. And I don't even think it needs to be a government. It just needs to be an agreement. Whatever happened to the day when a man's word was a man's word? If you could get back to that, you wouldn't need a government. You'd do what you could and what you were responsible for, and things would be done. The things that need to be done. Our people being fed. Our elderly being taken care of. It's way, way past time, folks. Way past time. Anyway, I don't know how we get from where we are today to where we go to shut this government down, but if anybody has ideas and you want to email those to me, we've got to start somewhere. We've got to take action. We've got to do it state by state by state by state. And every state must decide that they are no longer going to comply with any federal law. None. And for those of you that are worried about being attacked when the government shuts down, oh my God, they're going to come here and kill us. Wait a minute, we own all that military supply that you've been paying for. And if we really do come under attack, myself and many others like me will jump in one of them tanks and blow the shit out of the first guy that thinks he's taking this land from us. But I can guarantee you, your standing in the world would be so much better if you shut down this government and you made an agreement to pay what we've used and you stopped killing people. We don't need to rectify the health care or the food, or we need to shut the people down that are controlling it. We know how to feed ourselves. We know how to take care of our grandmas, and we know how to defend this land. We did it before we had tanks and planes. I sure as fuck think we can do it now. Much love. Many thanks. And I'm not even going to put any links below, because your job is to tell me I'm wrong. See you soon.
You've got to put your body upon the gears and upon the wheels, upon the leaves.